I'll discuss the types of inheritance here. Tell me how many types of inheritance we have? Wait, types of inheritance here. So types of inheritance. How many types of inheritance we have generally? We have the 5 types of inheritance here. What are the 5 types? Tell me. Any idea? The first one is what? Single inheritance. Single inheritance means one parent class contains one child class. Exactly, that is called which inheritance here? Single inheritance. So no, one parent class exactly contains how many child class? One child class, right? That is called single inheritance. Any explanation required? Yeah? So single inheritance. Good. Coming to single inheritance. If you want, you can make the example format. So what does single inheritance says? Tell me here. Yeah? Just a class parent. Tell me class parent. This parent class, I don't want to write anything, pass keyword, class child, child is extending from the parent, right? That's it. This is called single inheritance. The second one is, tell me here, second one is the multi-level inheritance. Multi-level inheritance means level by level. Level by level. What is the level by level here, tell me? Multi-level inheritance. So coming to the multi-level inheritance, I have the class here. The class A, I don't want anything pass keyword. I make the class B. Class B is extending from which class here? A class. I don't want anything pass keyword. And I can declare the class C. The class C is extending from which class here? B class. Just I don't want anything pass. Grandfather, father and child here. Well, this is called grandfather. This is called grandfather. This is called father. This is called what? Father, right? This is father. What about this one here? Child. This is called multi-level inheritance. I hope the point is clear, right? Multi-level inheritance. The third one. What is the third one here? Simply can take the multiple inheritance. What about multiple inheritance? Tell me. Multiple inheritance. Multiple parent classes here. Class A is there. I can write the pass here. I can have the class B is there. Class B is also, you can write the pass here. And you can take the class C. The class is extending from A comma B class. Here one child class contains how many parent classes here? Two parent classes, right? Like more than one parent class. That is called multiple inheritance. Single inheritance here, one father with one child. Multi-level inheritance, father, child, grandfather, father and child. Multiple inheritance. What is the multiple inheritance here? Wait, tell me, what is the multiple inheritance? Multiple fathers and one child. Number 4. What is the number 4 here? Simply can write the hierarchical inheritance. Which one here? So hierarchical inheritance, right? So no, hierarchical inheritance. Coming to the hierarchical inheritance, tell me, what is the hierarchical inheritance? Wait, tell me, hierarchical inheritance. What about hierarchical here? If you take the class A, I am not explaining anything, pass keyword. Hierarchical means one father contains multiple kids. Multiple childs. So here, what about here? Multiple. So parent classes, right? That's it. One child class with multiple parent classes here. Here one parent class with multiple child classes. See, for example, class B, if you take the class B is extending from which class here? Class A. If you don't want to write anything, pass. If you take the class C is also from which class here? A class. Simply can make the pass, right? That's it. What is the hierarchical in here? Our fathers are best example here. Every father contains more than one kid, right? This is my father. My father contains kid 1 and kid 2 or not. B is extending A and C is also extending A, right? So, no, that's it. The last type is what? Hybrid inheritance, right? Hybrid. Hybrid inheritance is always combination of two inheritances. Hybrid inheritance, right? Coming to the hybrid inheritance, it is a combination of multiple plus hierarchical. Why multiple plus what? So hierarchical, right? That's it. So these are the 5 types of inheritance we have in Python here, actually. What are the 5 types? Tell me here. Single inheritance. మల్టీలో ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, థర్డ్ వన్ ఇస్ మల్టిపుల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, సింగిల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, మల్టీలో ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, మల్టిపుల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, హైరారికల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, లాస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ వాట్ హైబ్రిడ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. హైబ్రిడ్ ఈస్ అ కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ వాట్ మల్టిపుల్ ప్లస్ హైరారికల్, రైట్? దాట్స్ ఎట్. క్లియర్ అంత పాయింట్ ఈస్ క్లియర్. టోటల్ హౌ మెనీ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్ వీ హావ్? ఫైవ్ టైప్స్. టెల్ మీ యర్ వన్ ఫాదర్ విత్ మోర్ దెన్ వన్ కిడ్ విచ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, వన్ ఫాదర్ విత్ మల్టిపుల్ కిడ్స్ విచ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, వన్ ఫాదర్ విత్ మల్టిపుల్ కిడ్స్ హైరారికల్, రైట్? సోనే గ్రాండ్ ఫాదర్ ఫాదర్ అండ్ చైల్డ్ దీని వచ్చిన ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, గ్రాండ్ ఫాదర్ ఫాదర్ అండ్ చైల్డ్ వచ్చిన ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, సింపుల్ క్యాన్ సే మల్టీ లెవెల్, రైట్? మల్టిపుల్ పేరెంట్ క్లాసెస్ విత్ వన్ చైల్డ్ దీని వచ్చిన ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, మల్టిపుల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్ ఆర్ నాట్. టోటల్ హౌ మెనీ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్ వీ హావ్? టోటల్ ఫైవ్ టైప్స్. వే క్లియరా? దట్స్ ఆల్ అబౌట్ యువర్ ఫైవ్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్ సార్. ఎనీ డౌట్స్? ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ ఐల్ గివ్ వన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ రిగార్డింగ్ దిస్ పాయింట్స్, రిగార్డింగ్ మల్టీ లెవెల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. What is the multi-level inheritance is, you can take the class A. The class A, I am declaring def M1 method. And to represent this method, it belongs to class self keyword. Then you can write the print something. This is my M1 method. Sorry, this is my M1 method, right? That's all. And you can make the class B. The class B is extending from which class here? A class, right? Here also I want to declare one method, def M2 method. To represent this method, it belongs to class self keyword. Just you can write the print message, print of this is my which method here, M2 method. That's it. What about class C? The class C extending from which class here? B class. To represent this method, it belongs to class def M3 method. And to represent this method, it belongs to class, we have to self keyword, right? That's it. Simply can write the print message, print of this is my which method here? M3 method, right? That's it. Well, this is called which inheritance, sir? Multi-level inheritance. The multi-level inheritance, once you create the object of child class, what is the child here? C equal to, simply can write the capital C of. Small c is a reference variable here. Just this is called reference variable, C of, this is called object. By using child class object, we can call all the parent members, right? We can call c.m1 possible, we can call c.m2 possible, we can call c.m3 possible, right? Good. So it is always recommended to create the object of which class here? Child class. Always recommended to create the object of child class or not? M1, M2 and M3 method. This is called which inheritance here? Wait, this is called which inheritance? Previously how many examples we done? Total 6 examples I think. This is the 7th example. Regarding this is 7th example, right? This is my example number how much? 7th example. So which inheritance it is the multi-level inheritance, right? That's it. Then sir, give me one more example. Example number 8. What the example number 8 tell me here? I will give one example regarding which inheritance you want here. Hierarchical inheritance. Hierarchical inheritance, I will give an example. In the hierarchical inheritance means what? If you take the class vehicle. So if we can write the vehicle class vehicle. So class vehicle. So it contains some method here. What the method here? Simply can write the disp one. To represent this method, it belongs to class self keyword. Simply can write the print message, print of, tell me print of, so vehicle info, right? That's it. So what I said, hierarchical inheritance, one parent class contains multiple childs, right? Multiple childs. If you take the class car, car is a vehicle, it is from vehicle, right? Yes or no? Yeah. Class is extending from vehicle or not? That's it. So def, you can make the disp 2 here. To represent this is belongs to class self keyword. Simply can write the print message. This is my car info, right? That's it. Yes or no? Car info. You can make the class plane. Wait, class plane, right? So plane is also so vehicle. I'm writing here. So good. Extending from vehicle, right? That's it. So if you want, you can write some disp 3 here, def disp 3, right? Yes or no? Disp 3. To represent this message belongs to class self keyword as usual. You can write the print message, print of. Tell me whatever this one here, plain info, right? Some messages you can write, that's it, plain info. Okay, clear? That's all. Here I am creating object of vehicle here. Once you creating object of vehicle, V equal to, so vehicle of, then you can call only v dot, which function here? Disp1 only. am creating object of car, c equal to car of. Why c equal to car of? C dot, what the function we have to call? Display to right, that's it. What are plane here? So p equal to, tell me p equal to plane, right? So now p equal to plane of, then you can call the p dot display 3 r naught, that's it. Why p dot display, right? That's it. Simply can run this code, python first dot py. Plane vehicle is not defined, v is the capital, right? We have to extend from the vehicle, that's it. Vehicle info, car info, and plane info, right? Good. This is inheritance is very very important while doing the polymorphism abstraction concept here, because always we have to extend from other classes, right? Inheritance is important while doing overriding concepts, polymorphism concept, encapsulation, and abstraction concept, right? That's it. Well, this is which inheritance here? Hierarchical inheritance. Clear? That's it. Well, how many examples we done? 8 examples. Then sir, give me one more example. Example number 9. Coming to the example number 9 here, as you know, multiple inheritance you want, you can make the multiple inheritance. What about multiple, right? Multiple inheritance, multiple parent classes, right? With one kid. So coming to the multiple parent classes, class I'm writing the parent one here. Parent one, you can make the def m1 method. To represent this method, is belongs to class self keyword. Simply can write the print message, print off. This is my which method here? Parent one m1 method, right? That's it. Let me take the one more parent class. Class, we can take the parent 2. We make it the capital letter, parent 2, right? Parent 2, this is also parent class anyhow. So def, here also I'm declaring m2 method here. So to represent this method, is belongs to class self keyword. Self keyword, simply can write the print message, the print of, this is my parent, which method here? M2 method or not? This is my parent to m2 method. Let me take the class child. What about child class? Child class can extend multiple parent class, right? Parent 1 comma parent 2. Okay, that's it. Assume the child class contains one method, def m3 method, right? To represent this method, is belongs to class, we have to write the self keyword. Simply can write the print message, print of, this is my child m3 method, right? That's it. Now tell me, now child class contains how many methods total? Now this child class is extending two classes, right? Parent 1 and parent 2. Parent 1 contains one method, parent 2 also contains one method. Then child contains one method. Total child class contains how many methods here? Total 3 methods. Then create the object of child class. C equal to child of, then you can call the c.m1, then you can call the c.m2, then you can call the c.m3. That's it. So now simply run it. Parent 1 m1 method, parent 2 m2 method, child m3 method are not. This is called one child class contains how many parent classes here? Two parent classes, right? This is called which inheritance? Multiple inheritance. We clear? That's all, guys. This is called multilevel inheritance. This is called hierarchical inheritance. This is called multiple inheritance. Clear? Good. I'll give one more example regarding this inheritance here. Example number 10. Coming to this example number 10 here. Good. In this example here, we'll discuss the parent class in detail. Parent and child classes once. Parent and child classes, right? That's it. Here what I will do, you know, the class you can take the person class. Class. Assume the person class contains one constructor. Def __ init __ of. To represent this function, this constructor belongs to class self keyword. Comma, it contains first name, comma, last name. So obviously the constructor arguments are which variables here? Constructor arguments are obviously local variables. Can please make this local variable to class variables, right? To make the local variable to class variables, we have to use a self keyword. Self dot first equal to first. Why self dot first equal to, here you can make the first, right? That's it. Next one is a self dot last equal to self dot last name, right? Last equal to last, right? That's it. This is called person class constructor. Person class constructor contains one constructs the two arguments. They can take the class employee class. Employee class is obviously extending from which class? A person class. It's extending person class, but employee class contains one constructor, def underscore underscore init underscore underscore. It is expecting three arguments. The first name, and expecting last name, and it expecting id value. It is expecting first name and last name and id value, right? That's it. As per the rules, here three variables are there. To represent the constructor is belongs to class, self keyword required, observe carefully. And these three variables are which variables here, obviously. Here also these are called local variables, right? With these also which variables here? Local variables are not. Local variables. Generally, we have to convert these local values to the class variables, right? To convert the local values to class variables, self dot first equal to, we have to make the first. Next one is self dot last equal to, tell me last. Next one is what? Self dot id equal to, last one is what? Self dot id equal to id, right? That's it. Because you are making your local variables to the class variables. Why rather than actually, let me take the one this function here to print the data. Def disp. So to print this function is belongs to class self keyword. Here I want print the data. To print the data means constructor arguments are local variables, right? Local variables we cannot print inside the disp. Then what you have to do? We have to make your local variables to the class variables, right? To convert your local variable to the class variables, we have to use this code. Okay, but tell me here, these two lines of code, first name and last name, this already present the parent class constructor, right? Instead of these two lines of code, here let me call the parent class constructor. Then how to call the parent class constructor here? Total, how many ways are there to call the parent class constructor? Two ways. One is super keyword, one is by using class name, right? Super data underscore underscore, tell me underscore underscore init underscore underscore of by passing the first current class members, right? First and first comma last. That's it. Sir, no, that's all. See, here I want print the data here. To print the data here, print of, tell me print of employee ID. Employee ID equal to parenthesis. Next one is employee name equal to employee first name. First name equal to parenthesis. So employee last name. Employee last name equal to parenthesis, right? That's it. I have to substitute these values. Then how to substitute the values here? By using which function here? Format function, right? Format of. Then how to substitute the values? By using self keyword, right? Because class variables. To represent the class variables, always we have to use a self keyword, right? So self data. Self data. First, comma, self dot. Sorry, first one is idea. Good. Then we have to make the self dot id. Next one is what? Self dot first, comma, the last one is self dot last, right? That's it. Then create the object of employee class here. Employee e1 equal to employee of employee construct expecting how many arguments total? Three arguments. First, last, id. First one is what? So Ratan, the last name is simply can write the Adanki. So what the id for this one here? 111. Then can please call the disp method. E1 dot which function here? Disp, right? That's it. So no, here E1 dot disp or not? It's saying error message. What error message here? Disp, in the disp, which one is not defined here? Last is not defined. Where the last? Self dot id line number, how much you can check the error message? 11 number 11. Print did first name last name dot format self dot id self dot first self dot, like that. When you get the error message, slowly you can check the patience important here. As a programmer, always patience important. Always try slowly, you can check the data, right? That's it. Simply can run this code now. So you'll get the output or not. For the employee ID. Employee ID is a 111. Employee name, first name is Ratan and last name is Adanki, right? Like that. For the single class, you can create multiple objects, right? Employee of, you can make the Anu. So comma, you can make the, so DS, SMS, that's it. You can make the 222, right? Then simply can call the e2 dot, which function you have to call here, e2 dot disp, right? That's it. Simply can run this code. Will you get output or not? That's all, guys. So here, to call the parent class constructor, we have one more approach. What is one more approach here? By using class name. How to call a class name? Person dot, tell me, underscore underscore init. We underscore underscore init underscore underscore of. But when we call the data by using class name, the first argument must be the which argument here? Self argument. Self, first, comma, last. I hope you guys understood or not. See, super means representing directly object. What about person? This is a class name, right? While calling the class name, here we must pass a self because to representing object. Representing object, right? That's it. So this is also possible here. You can make this line is a comment mode. You can run this code. That line is perfectly valid, right? That's all. So we can call the parent class constructor in how many ways total? Two ways. One is by using super. Super is recommended approach here. Okay. Second one is by using class name, right? That's it. My example is clear. 10th example. That's it. But one of the student is asking a small question. The small case. Ratan sir, I don't want to write the this method. Whenever I am printing my reference variable e1, I want to print my data. What is question here? Whenever I am printing the reference variable, I want to print my data. Whenever you are printing reference variable, one function is executed, right? Which function here? Whenever you are printing reference variable, one function will be executed. Previously, while discussing class concept, we discussed that point, right? Tell me here, which function executed? Underscore underscore str, right? Underscore underscore. The underscore underscore str always returns the string data or not. Return type is like this. Return simply get in that value. String plus anything, it will become string data only, right? That's it. Whenever I'm printing the reference variable also, we'll get the same output or not. So now previously I'm taking this method. In the this method, I'm printing the data. What about now here? He's asking the question. Then sir, whenever I'm printing the reference variable, I want to print the data. Whenever you are printing the reference variable, then how to call the data here? By using the function, by overriding the function, which function? Underscore underscore str or not? Clear? That's all, guys. Simply you can save this application also. If you want, you can make this is example number how much? This is example number 11. We clear? And example number 12, if you want, I'll make one more example. Example number 12. Coming to the example number 12, where one of the student is asked one more small question. I have the class parent class. I don't want to write anything pass keyword simply. I can make the class child. Child of which one here? Parent class. You can make the colon. I don't want to write anything, simply can make the pass. Then he is creating object of parent class p equal to parent of. I'm creating object of child class c equal to child of. Okay, I'm creating both object of parent class and child class. So no, just I want check the hierarchy here. To check the type of the object, we have to use one function, is instance function. Which function here? Is instance function. Sir, no, is instance, right? Is instance of. So p is p is the instance of parent or not? Anyway, p is instance of parent only, right? True. Just it is checking the hierarchy or not. So c is the instance of child or not. So tell me, c is instance of child only, right? Any problem here? There is no problem. True only. Whatever next one here. So c is the instance of parent or not? Anyway, c is instance of parent only, right? Because c is a child class, parent is a parent class. True only. If the relationship is the child to parent, you'll get the true only here. For example here, c is the child of object or not? See, my child is a parent of my child class. Who is the parent? Parent. For this parent class, who is the grandfather here? Object, right? By default, object class here. Then child class is from object class or not? You'll get the true only. Yes or no? Clear? Good. If you want, you can check it. P is also from object class or not? Exactly, it is true because by default, our class is a child class of object. By default, our class is a child of the object, right? That's it. Just it is there in the hierarchy or not. To check the hierarchy or not, we have to use the isInstance method. isInstance method here. Okay, sir, when it return the false. See, for example, I want check c isInstance isInstance of. I have to check p is the instance of child or not. Why p is instance of child? Or child is instance of p, na? Anyway, see, for example, c is the instance of object, c is instance of parent, right? Okay, but p is child is recommended or not recommended, we'll get the false. So no, we'll get the false or not. So no, yeah. See, here I'm checking my c is the c is the instance of object. That's okay, right? Good, no problem. In this case, it returns a false error anyhow. Clear? That's all, guys. To check the is instance, to check the type of the object, it'll go with which one near is instance, right? That's all. We examples are clear? That's all, guys. This is all about which concept here? The inheritance concept. Any doubts regarding inheritance here? Tell me about the definition of inheritance. The process of creating new class by using the properties of existing class. That is called which concept here? Inheritance concept. So how many examples we done total? 12 examples. We will make the two videos here, 22 and 23. 1 hour class is there, right? We will make the half an hour. I'll explain all the points. You can check it. This is the video class number 22 and 23. Both classes here. Yeah. Oops, inheritance concept. So Python is object-oriented programming language. We have to represent everything in the form of the object. The first object-oriented programming language is Simula 67. First, we will focus on class versus object. Class is a logical entity, contains logics of the application, whereas object is a physical entity representing the memory, right? Class is a blueprint, decides object creation. Without class, there is no object. Based on the single blueprint, possible to create the multiple object, but every object occupies memory. Declare the class by using which keyword here? Class keyword. In Python 2.7, our class is not child class of object. But Python 3.x, our class is by default child class of object. So I done the first example to check that outputs. The first example, in 3.x I'm executing, you'll get all the trues, right? In 2.7, I'm executing this application, we'll get the first one is a false, false and a true. Third one is why true? Explicitly we are making object class, right? That's it. So in the programming, in OOPS, OOPS is the methodology here to design applications. Generally, what are the four building blocks of OOPS? Inheritance, polymorphism, encapsulation, and abstraction. In this video, we'll focus on inheritance. What do you mean inheritance here? The process of creating new class by using the properties of existing class. That is called inheritance. Class, parent, and child. You can create the object of parent class and child class, but recommended to create the object of which class here? Child class. Why? When we create the object of child class, it is possible to access both parent and child properties. Example number 3, calling the superclass method by using super keyword here. By using super keyword. Sir, no, yeah? That's it. Superclass variables here. To represent the superclass variables, you can call the self also. Self.a and self.b. First it will check the self.a, self.b means first it will check the class variables in the child class. Child class contains any class variables here? No. Then only priority goes to parent class. See, for the third example, we can make the self.m1 also here. When you make the self.m1, first it will check the m1 method in the child class. Not available, it will check in the parent class. If you want, you can check the execution part. Example number 5. We have the variables, right? Variables with the same names. Global have the AB, parent also AB, child also AB, right? No, that's it. Then in this case, self.a, self.b means first you check the priority in the child class. But once again, if you are writing self.a, self.b means once again child class only execute, right? But in this case, I want to represent my parent class members. Then you simply can go with the super.a, that's it. Then example number 6, calling the super class constructors. So in the first example, child class, there is no constructor, but I am trying to create the object of child class. Then what happened here? The child class constructor is not available, then parent class constructor will be executed. అండ్ కేస్ టూ, బట్ పేరెంట్ క్లాస్ కంటెన్స్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్, చైల్డ్ ఆల్సో కంటెన్స్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్. దెన్ ఉచ్ క్లాస్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్ ఎగ్జిక్యూటర్, చైల్డ్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్ విల్ బి ఎగ్జిక్యూటెడ్. అండ్ కేస్ త్రీ, ఇప్పుడు కేస్ త్రీ ద పేరెంట్ క్లాస్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్ ఇన్ ద చైల్డ్ క్లాస్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్, టు కాల్ ద పేరెంట్ క్లాస్ కన్స్ట్రక్టర్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు యూజ్ ద టూ వేస్ యాక్చువల్లీ. వన్ ఈజ్ బై యూజింగ్ సూపర్ కీవర్డ్, వన్ ఈజ్ బై యూజింగ్ క్లాస్ నేమ్. బట్ వైల్ కాలింగ్ ద క్లాస్ నేమ్, ద ఫస్ట్ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్ మస్ట్ బి ద సెల్ఫ్ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్. దట్స్ ఆల్ గైస్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ ద టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్. హౌ మెనీ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్ ఇన్ పైథాన్? టోటల్ ఫైవ్ టైప్స్. టోటల్ ఫైవ్ టైప్స్. సింగిల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, వన్ ఫాదర్ విత్ వన్ చైల్డ్. వాట్ అబౌట్ మల్టీ లెవెల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్? లెవెల్ బై లెవెల్, గ్రాండ్ ఫాదర్, ఫాదర్ అండ్ చైల్డ్. మల్టిపుల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, మల్టిపుల్ ఫాదర్స్, వన్ కిడ్. హైరార్కల్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్, వన్ ఫాదర్ విత్ మల్టిపుల్ కిడ్స్. హైబ్రిడ్ ఇన్హెరిటెన్స్ ఇస్ అ కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ మల్టిపుల్ ప్లస్ హైరార్కల్. అండ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ నెంబర్ సెవెన్ ఐ షోన్ రిగార్డింగ్ మల్టీ లెవెల్. Once you create the object of C class, you can call the, all the father properties and grandfather properties also, right? Next we done the hierarchical inheritance. Hierarchical means one parent with multiple kids, car extends vehicle, plane also extends vehicle, right? And example number 9, we'll discuss the multiple inheritance, multiple parent classes here. And example number 10, we are calling the parent class constructor by passing the arguments also. And here I'm printing the dist method to print the data. Example number 11, I don't want dist method. Whenever I'm printing the reference variable, I want print my data. Whenever you are printing the reference variable, then which function executed? Underscore underscore str will be executed. Then you can make the underscore underscore str. That's it. And example number 12, just checking the instance, is instance or not. That's all guys. If you have any queries, can please mail to my mail ID ratna5256@gmail.com. I'm placing all the videos, and if you want YouTube access, just call that number. And if you have any queries and any information and any material, you can mail to my mail ID. Then I'll check that mail and forward the, I'll give the response. Clear? So thank you guys. Thanks for watching. Can please like the video and comment the video and subscribe to our channel to get the more updates. Thank you guys. Bye.